You actually played with an impressive list of pretty well-known quarterbacks. So I'd like to go through each one of them and hear a little something about them, all right? Let's kick things off with your boy, Jay Cutler. Aside from being responsible from your finger, what else can you tell me about trying to catch passes from number six?
Best hair out of all the quarterbacks I played with, Jay Cutler. And the thing about Jay Cutler, he's highly intelligent, really fun, and he's just a funny guy that throws a rocket for an arm. He threw me a lot of balls, footballs. Pause.
Was he a good leader? Like, did he get you guys motivated? Was he really engaged with getting everybody fired up?
Jay's role wasn't to get you fired up. If you work with Jay, it's BYOE. Bring your own energy.
All right, somebody who doesn't have as great a haircut as Jay Cutler, but is a pretty good quarterback, or was a good quarterback, and that's Tony Romo. You played with him down in Dallas. Any thoughts on Tony Romo?
Tony Romo probably throws one of the prettiest passes I've seen, especially like it's soft at the end when it touches your hands. Like it's never like boom, like Jay Cutler is like boom, like damn Jay, slow down, homie. You know, then, but Tony, I ain't catch many passes from Tony, to be honest, but he was a really cool dude. I mean,
is he really cool?
He's a really cool dude that's not like cool, like you want to hang out with him, but he was cool.
What?
In a frat boy way.
Who on the team would you hang out with if not Tony?
Well, I hung out with Jay Ratliff because he's the realest I know.
So after Dallas, you went to the New York Giants. What was it like catching passes from Eli?
Well, the thing about Eli Manning is he doesn't have the best hair or the cutest face as some of these other quarterbacks on this list.
Why is that a qualification for being a good quarterback?
Because he has to look at him in the huddle.
Everybody's looking at you at the huddle. I think you should be nice to look at, right? It's like having a painting on the wall, right? But the thing about Eli, he's probably the funniest out of all the quarterbacks I played with.
Funny? Is he funnier than me?
Nah, no one's funnier than you.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Except for Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy.
Hey, hold on. You know what I'm saying? I mean, in their prime.
Eli, but when Eli throws the ball, it falls down at the end. So, I don't know.
All right, well, speaking of like really handsome quarterbacks, you played with the GOAT of cheekbones, and that's TB12. Tom Brady, that's a handsome American man there. So what do you have to say about catching balls from Tom Brady?
Well, when I caught balls from footballs from Tom, the thing about Tom is he's probably the coolest guy that everybody wants to be like, as far as he's like the James Bond of the NFL. I mean, he has the Aston Martin, he has the suits, he's sponsored by Gucci, okay. And he just rolls around very cool. He walks around, when Tom takes a shower, he wears a robe in the locker room. That's how rich he is. He wears a robe in the locker room, he has a shower kit, and he just looks like when I went there, I was like, I should get a robe. If this is the standard of the Patriots locker room, I too need a Tom Brady. I believe it was Cashmere as well.
What about
only the best for Tom.
What about Jimmy Garoppolo?
It depends where you're from, because some people say Grappolo. And
Grappolo.
Yeah, we called him the Italian Stallion. Is he Italian? I have no idea.
Did you ever talk to him? I mean, I know y'all were at different, you know, places in y'all career. Would you ever have conversations with him?
I always talked to Jimmy. Jimmy was a really young guy who, you know, finding his way in the world when I was around. And anytime you're looking for your way in the world, the best person that has the map to the world is moi. You know what I'm saying?
You had your best games as a Patriot with Jimmy G.
Yeah, Jimmy liked to throw the ball to the tight end. So if there's a good tight end for the San Francisco 49ers, I would look into drafting him on fantasy football, Liz.
Oh, callback.
Last but not least, you played with the guy who got paid this summer, Aaron Rodgers. Talk to me about your time up in Green Bay.
I would ask him to borrow some money, but a lot of Packer fans feel like I already got money I didn't deserve from them. But I would say the thing about Aaron Rodgers is I've never seen anyone who could throw the ball the way that he could throw the ball. He throws the ball in places and he could throw, like, you could tell him, hey, hit the light bulb. Oh, hit that dragonfly. Hey, he's like a sharpshooter. He's like the guy in Shooter. What's the name of his movie?
Who's
a
Wahlberg?
Shooter? Yeah, he's like Mark Wahlberg in Shooter, except for as a quarterback. Never. And he has big calves.
He does. I played in the golf tournament with him, and I saw he has some big calves.
Like, why are your calves so big? You play quarterback, but he does calf raises every morning. I caught him.
He has punter legs.
I caught him one day. Yeah, he definitely has punter legs. I caught him one day doing calf raises, and he's like, oh, no, these are natural. These are my natural calves. All right.
I'm on to you, Aaron.
Yeah,
I'm
on to you, yeah.